we have two primary focuses or missions. One, at least half my clientele or more come there for personal protection self-defense programs, okay. which we have several different programs, as you'll see throughout the rest of the program today. And the second part is for the martial art enthusiasts. People want to get in fitness, fun and fitness, that type of idea. So we have sport combat as well and such.
Take it up to a little bit of a higher intensity level if
correct,
you're interested.
Correct.
In your mission statement, you guys talk about that you provide a safe, progressive, enjoyable, and challenging training environment. Now, self-defense can seem really intimidating, especially the stuff you guys were already doing today. But how important is it that you stress to your students that it's supposed to be safe and enjoyable?
Well, the training has to be safe. Violence itself is very ugly. As far as having to deal with that kind of situation. I don't know any more stressful situations than having your life on the line or your serious bodily harm or even being mugged or robbed and stuff like that. That wears on your self-esteem and such. So it's already an ugly enough issue or a scenario. So we try and make, we take the situation seriously or the subject seriously, but the training should be an enjoyable process. Plus, the retention is much better when they can enjoy the process after the end of class. That was a lot of fun.
Absolutely. So. I know even just the thought of learning this today is kind of solemn, thinking that, you know, you need these skills because it's a realistic thing that maybe one day something dangerous could happen to you. So I'm going to...
If you're ever in a situation where you find yourself in trouble, you can defend yourself and feel more confident knowing that you've got those skills.
Just in case getting jumped or anything. It's good if you're alone, unlike white. On a Friday if you lose track of your buddies.
You could protect yourself when you're in danger or your friends or family.
Okay, and so who should take this program?
Well, it's for everybody.
For everybody?
It's adult, co-ed, and in a typical citizens protection program, I might have all the way from 13, 14, all the way up to people in their 50s and the whole range in between,
okay.
essentially.
And so what are some of the things you learn? I know you talk a little bit about trusting your gut feeling in so many words.
Well, the big thing is that we try to handle the whole spectrum of personal protection and violence, okay? A to Z. A, you know, the beginning meaning enhancing your awareness. Because if you can see it in advance, then you can avoid it in advance.
Well, and so many people, too, I think just walk through life. They're so busy. They have other things on their mind, and they just don't even notice what's going on around them.
Absolutely. Yeah. Big yes. The second thing is sometimes maybe you're caught off guard, or the person encroaches in your space faster than you can comprehend or be aware of. Then we don't have a verbal protection strategy. So being able to talk yourself out of the situation.
Okay.
So once those two are exhausted, okay, then it's when your back's against the wall and you have no other choice, then you might have to use physical tactics.
So then what would be some of the things that you would say to try and talk yourself out of a dangerous situation?
Well, the main things which you want to do is don't use words that either jeopardize or the possibility of defusing the situation or antagonize the person further, essentially, though. Another strategy is to start asking questions. If you can get him talking all the time, he's thinking less and less about trying to strike you or hit you and such, though.
Okay.
Ideally, you want to be able to strike that one little human nerve inside them that they sort of see you as a human being and not as a possible victim.
Yeah.
And then they say maybe they might leave you alone, essentially. And there's lots of stories to demonstrate that,
So. It sounds like you definitely need a lot of, well, we talked a little bit about confidence, courage, because if someone came up to me and was about to attack me, I think I'd probably freak out. How do you teach yourself not to
do
that?
Well, that's the training then.
Okay.
Okay, so one thing is that the training methodology has a big impact on that, though. The mind learns the information, but you want the body to remember the information when the brown matter hits the fan, basically, and stuff, though, so when it gets really serious and such.
So it just comes naturally.
Exactly.
Okay, do you want to show me some things?
Yes.
Okay.
Essentially, whatever the situation is, you want to be able to intercept, stabilize, and resolve. Doesn't matter the scenario. It's always going to be intercept, stabilize, resolve. I'm going to show you an interceptor tactic called the dive.
Okay.
The dive is one of the simplest tactics I can show, because I believe it's genetic. I have no scientific proof for this, but when you were a kid, just going a bit about being an easy, if I pushed you, what did you do back as a kid? Usually you'd push me back,
yeah,
then off.
Exactly.
And I push you, what do you do?
Push
you become
again.
The shoving match.
Right.
Now, sometimes what happens is I push me some more, just push on. Then it becomes something like this then.
Yeah.
What I'm going to do is take this pushing motion, call it a dive, and I turn it into a tactic for you. So here's what I want you to do, though. Okay. So just face it that way.
Okay.
Just bend your knees. Okay. You're in a talking posture. You're going to drop a level, push off of that back leg, and slide in like so. Just simple as that then. Okay. So drop a level, push in, and slide in. I'm only going to do this 2-3 times.
Okay?
Again,
okay.
Hands are up, talking, drop that level, slide in. Got that now?
Okay.
Now what I want you to do is you're going to drop a level, you're going to stack hand on top of hand and push straight out like so. There you go. One more time.
Okay.
One more time. And then we're going to do it with the pad then. Boom. Okay. There you go. Now, if I make any, I want the audience to realize that I got 120 seconds here to show her a movie where we might take 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour to work a move now. Now we're going to do it with the pad though.
Okay.
So what's going to happen here is that I want you to hold the pad just like this.
Okay.
Boom. You're going to do this to me. So you're just going to stand in front, talking posture, drop that level, and just boom, pop straight back then.
Okay.
That's what I want you to do to me now. Okay, move back a little bit.
Okay.
Talking posture, drop a level, palm on top of palm, right up on the top here, not in the bottom. Okay, not bad. Now what I want you to do is hit me harder.
Okay, hit me harder if you're giving me
permission. Move back some more.
Okay.
Move back some more. That's why I'm having you move. I don't want to be into those things.
Yeah, okay. Okay. So I'll give you one more.
That part's hard. Not bad, not bad. Better, better.
One more. Let me do one
yes.
more.
Yes. See? One. She's okay. getting excited now. That's what I like to see. Okay. Harder. Go harder. For it. Just go for it. Not bad. Not bad.
Okay. Okay. I got to stop beating you up more. Now. One more.
More.
Okay. Sorry.
Best
sorry,
one
Dean,
yet.
The director. I have
dropping
to.
Foster.
Okay.
Drop that level. Crash in.
Better, better.
Okay.